Soil is the uppermost layer of the land surface. Plants depend on this layer for nutrients, water, and for physical support. There are several factors that result in soil formation. There are five different factors that result in soil formation. First is the parent rock, second is the relief, third is time, fourth is climate, and then fifth is plant and animal or organisms. So the first three are known as passive factors, and the last two are, or the fourth or fifth, are known as active factors of soil formation. So first we'll be dealing with the parent rock, that is the rock that helps in the formation of soil. So soil formation, the type of soil, texture of soil and other properties depend upon the parent material or the rock out of which the soil is formed. So we learnt earlier during this session only that rocks disintegrate to form soil. So the kind of rock is there that will determine what kind of soil will be formed. So soil is dependent upon its parent material or the parent rock, type of soil, the chemicals found in it, the minerals found in it, all depend upon the parent material of the soil mainly, basically. Chemical composition, content, mineral content, fertility, etc. The second factor is relief. Relief means the slope of the land. So it affects the degree of erosion of parent material. How does the relief affects? It affects the degree of erosion of parent material, how much the parent material is getting eroded, and then it depends upon, and then very slopy land, what happens? The sediments get carried away or it gets transported easily. So a very thin layer of soil can be found there. So in mountainous area, very thin layer of soil is formed, whereas in plain area, little plain area, thick layer of soil is found. Now the third factor is time. Soil formation, we all know, is a very, very slow process, and it takes thousands of years to form a thin layer of soil. So a well-developed soil takes very long period of time as a product of physical, chemical and biological process operating collectively, soil is formed. So time is also a factor that helps in formation of soil. The fourth factor is climate. It reduces difference caused by parent material. So climate is an active factor, as we discussed earlier, and it reduces the difference caused by parent material. It influences biological activities within the soil. So two different parent rocks may develop same type of soil in one climatic region and vice versa. So in different kind of climatic region, same parent rock material might develop into different rock or same rock. For example, granite and sandstone result in a sandy soil in Thar desert of India. So both of them, granite and sandstone, result in the formation of sandy soil. Impact of climate in soil formation. In what manner climate affects soil formation? So climate, you can see in the figure, a climate with its seasonal change in temperature, nature and distribution of precipitation, it results in the process of weathering, or it affects the process of weathering, then effectiveness of weathering, then results in the type of plants that is found in that area and type of animals that are found in that area. So climate results or affects these four other aspects, and then all these together have an effect in the formation of soil. Now the last factor of soil formation is plants and animals. These play an active role in transforming parent material. Dead plants and animals provide organic content to soil. The process of decay through bacterial action results in organic formation of organic matter, and which is known as humus. Humus is what is basically determines the fertility of the soil and enhances water retention capacity of the soil. So in this manner, humus, we all know, is organic matter, and then it through enhancing its fertility and enhancing the water retention capacity of the soil results in fertility of the soil. Now, we'll be dealing with soil horizons. What are soil horizons? Soil horizon is the layers of soil you can see in the picture. One picture is the two-dimensional picture and then another one is three-dimensional. So, here we all can see different layers of soil depending upon the color and the texture of the soil. So, the topmost soil, then subsoil, substratum and then unweathered parent materials. Depending upon the quality or characteristics of these layers, they are known as A horizon, E horizon, B horizon and C horizon. So, the topmost layer we have plants in it, it supports plant and as you can see in the figure also. So, now what is soil horizon, we'll be dealing in detail. The layer of soil which lies almost parallel to the surface is known as soil horizon. It has fairly distinctive soil properties. The distinctive layer are found in soils. So, they differ in physical or chemical composition which results from organic content or structure. There is display of horizons on a cross section through soil and this is known as soil profile. So, if we cut the soil in this manner and then so a cross section is found and so by cutting this we can see various layers of the soil and this this showing of the layers is known as soil profile. The cross section, when we cut it cross sectionally, layers of the soil are seen and this is known as soil profile. Now, different horizons of soil, different layers of soil. The first one, as I told you, is A horizon. This is the uppermost layer of the soil and it is rich in organic matter. The second one is E horizon. It contains clay particles and oxides of aluminium and iron. When water falls on it or rain occurs, it removes some of the minerals of this layer and the minerals get removed and there's downward seeping with the help of water. So, pure grains of sand or coarse silt is left in this horizon when the soil is finer particle is gets seeped in the next layer with the help of water. So, coarse material is left behind, sand or grains. The third layer is B horizon. It receives clay particles, aluminium and iron oxides and organic matter from the earlier layer, that is the E horizon. And so, what happens that it receives all these materials, these oxides, iron oxides, organic matter and fine clay particles etc. from the above layer and gets accumulated in this B layer, that is the third layer. The fourth one is the C horizon. It is basically not considered as soil, a part of soil because it consists of parent mineral matter. Now, we discussed about soil, how it is formed, the factors affecting soil and then soil horizons, various horizons of soil. Now, we will be dealing with soil erosion. So, what is soil erosion? You must have heard this word many a times in different contexts. So, what is soil erosion? Soil erosion is basically removal of soil at greater rate than its replacement. We all know that soil gets formed in a very, very, very long process, time period. So, soil erosion is basically removal of soil at a greater rate than it is replaced. So, replacement is very slow process. So, erosion takes place at a very fast rate. So, soil erosion is basically removal of soil. How does this occur, soil erosion? It occurs by natural agencies like water and wind, etc. There are different types of soil erosion. One is wind erosion, second is sheet erosion, third is rill erosion, and then fourth is gully erosion. We'll be dealing with all these four types of erosions, that is wind erosion, sheet erosion, rill erosion, and gully erosion in detail. First one is wind erosion. This basically takes place in desert areas or adjoining the deserts. So, what happens that in these areas, wind blows at a very fast pace. The velocity of wind is very fast, high. So, what happens it carries away the fine soil particles with it and then spreads it over in the adjoining area. So it also destroys the fertility of the adjoining area wherever the sand particles are deposited, and this is in this manner soil erosion takes place with the help of wind. Fine particles of sand and clay and soil sand etc. takes place, erosion takes place and deposition also takes place in the nearby areas. So lots of problematic things also take place for agriculture when these soil particles, sand particles are deposited in the fertile areas. So this takes place mainly in the states of Gujarat, Haryana, Punjab and Rajasthan of India. You can see some of the examples of wind erosion in the figure pictures. The first picture here, you can see the rock is being has got eroded. So bridge kind of structure has been formed, and this has formed mainly because of the action of wind. So the rock has got eroded, and holes in the rock, big structures of rocks has taken place, and now it has taken shape of bridge. The second picture shows removal of rock surface from a particular layer. The whiter band you can see, from there the wind has eroded and removed the rock particles. So in that, why this is in a banded form in that particular region only? Because if in that area the wind speed is the highest, so wind forces the removal of material in this area at a greater speed or get greater intensity. So this is also an example of erosion by wind action. Second type of soil erosion that takes place is through sheet erosion. What happens? What is sheet erosion? That soil or sediment is removed in the form of sheet for a larger area, like a sheet, the particles or sediments is removed. So water moves as a sheet and then washes away thin layers of soil with it. The most common, it is most commonly found in river beds and floodplains, where the water gets transported and then joins the rivers and small canals. There is removal of topsoil, so soil completely gets exhausted and becomes infertile. You can see in the picture, the water is flowing, and then with water, the muddy water, you can see muddy. Why this is muddy? Because it is carrying sediments or soil, the top layer of soil with it, and like a sheet, the whole layer, top layer is being removed from the surface of the earth. Now another type of soil erosion is through rill erosion. What is rill? You must be wondering. So rill is basically small thin channels that are formed on the earth surface when the water flows. So when rainfall happens, if the rain is taking place at a very heavy pace, so what you can see, water gets transported in thin channels, very thin channels like fingers or maybe thinner than that, and then these channels, these thin channels are known as rills. So as you can see in the picture also, these thin channels are known as rills. So in this manner, erosion of the top layer of the soil or rock is taking place, and soil erosion is taking place. So this is soil is there, and through rills, these water through rills, soil particles are being removed through water. These rills can be few centimeters in depth. Another type of soil erosion is gully erosion. So what is gully? Gully is the larger version of rill. So when rills get transformed into deep furrows, I mean the width increases as well as the depth of the rill. When rills gets increased, it takes the shape of gully. So when these several rills are found at a very vast area, and deeper rills are there and broader rills are there, gullies are there. So this is known as gully erosion, and water gets transported and it also carries away the soil with it. And when this is found at a very large area, vast area, it is known as badland. You must have heard about badlands of Chambal Valley. So what happens there, that these gullies take the place of shape of ravines. So larger rills are known as gullies, and larger gullies are known as, and deeper gullies are known as ravines. So ravines can be like tunnels or whole pathway in the top layer of the soil. These are very commonly found in the Chambal Valley of UP and Madhya Pradesh of India. Picture you can see, these are the ravines and badland of Chambal Valley. So you can see deep furrows, these are the top soil layer, how dissected they are. So many furrows are found, so many undulations can be found in this. So it's not a leveled land. So it becomes very much unsuitable for cultivation or agriculture because it's very much dissected. Ups and downs, so many ups and downs and they are there. It's not a leveled land. So it's good for nothing. You cannot grow anything on that. So this fertility is also lost and it's very undulating. You cannot grow anything on that. So what are the controlling factors of soil erosion? The controlling factors of soil erosion are velocity of water or wind, amount of water, erodibility of water, nature of slope, texture and structure of soil, then nature of precipitation and vegetation cover. So all these factors control soil erosion. Now soil conservation, it's another terminology related to soil erosion, that is soil conservation. What is the importance of soil conservation? What do we mean by soil conservation? So, since soil is an important natural resource and it sustains different types of lives directly or indirectly. So, and moreover, soil process is a very, very slow process as we already discussed. So, soil conservation is very important where we need to conserve the soil and its fertility. So, soil conservation involves methods which prevent soil from being removed. So, what are these methods of soil conservation? First is protection of forest. So, we need to protect the forest for conserving soil. Second is afforestation. First, we need to protect the already existing forest. Then, we need to do afforestation. That means, we need to plant forests. Then third is flood control. We need to control the flood. Fourth method of soil conservation is planned grazing. So overgrazing, you can see in the picture, grazing is taking place. But overgrazing, when we overgraze this soil, I mean the plant, etc. So what happens? Soil gets exposed and then loosening and washing away of soils takes place. Next is bunding. Bunds are what? Bunds are basically the construction or obstruction that is formed for controlling soil erosion. So, bunds are formed across the fields or such areas so that soil erosion stops or does not take place. Another method of soil conservation is bunding. So, bunds are formed to control soil erosion. Bunds means obstructions. You can see in the picture, bunds are being created or obstructions are being created. Then next is terracing. Terraces are formed to control soil erosion at a fast pace. Examples you can see in mountainous areas. Contour plowing is another method of conserving soil. Terracing you can see in the picture. Another method is adoption of strip farming. One strip is farmed and another is left fallow and likewise. Another is crop rotation. We all know crop rotation. Different crops are grown in different season in the same area. Another is reclamation of land. Reclamation of land means leveling of land for agriculture purposes so that there is less of soil erosion. Now, I would like to summarize what we learned today. We learned about weathering and its types, gradation, that is degradation and aggradation, soil, its importance, factors affecting soil formation, horizons of soil, soil erosion, its types, and then soil conservation and ways of conservation. Thank you.